We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Predator Hunters 2, Issue 1. This is from 2018. Our story opens in Afghanistan, where this guy is being taken by some extremists, and they are going to kill him for being a CIA agent. When something goes amiss, and they are all slaughtered, one's beheaded, the guy looks up while praying and sees a predator standing in front of him, holding the severed head of one of his captors. Then we cut to the Indian Ocean, and we learn a little bit about this group, the Hunters. What they don't really tell you until the very back of the book is that this is a secret society kind of thing, a secret group of people that hunt predators. It's not really explained well enough in the book. It kind of assumes you already know this, which actually I found kind of annoying because I hadn't read the first book. Apparently there's this family. One of them had fought a predator in the distant past, and he formed this group that's going to go out and hunt predators. Well, the last op went pretty badly, and this guy Swain sounds like he dropped the ball pretty bad, but he got out alive with a few other people, and they seem to kind of blame him. But now they have this footage from a secret feed that the CIA had access to, and thanks to, of course, those crazy Russians, got the information for this chick Jaya, who's the leader. So now they're gonna go out to Afghanistan and find the predator. There is a thing in the Amelia Islands where there's a crater that some guys are investigating, so that's interesting too. Once they get over to Afghanistan, Jaya and her team meet up with a guy named Malouk, who is going to be driving them in this armored vehicle, and they run into some soldiers that Jaya seems to recognize. I don't know who they are, but it moves up their timetable, and in the caverns, these Muslim extremists are getting slaughtered one by one by the Predator, and it is going to be a pretty bloody book. Now, overall, it was a pretty quick read. There is some gore in here. It is pretty brutal. It's definitely for mature audiences. A little bit of language, and there is definitely going to be some religious talk in here from a couple different religions. If any of that offends you, you're not going to want to read this, but it was pretty good. Script was by Chris Warner, art by Augustin Padilla, coloring by Niraj Menon. I'm sure I got that one wrong. Lettering, Michael Heisler, and I have cover A by Augustin Padilla. So overall, I thought the art was okay. It's a little bit of that heavy line pencil work. I don't really like that style too much, but for that type of style, it is pretty well done, and it's a Dark Horse book, so the paper quality is really good. Actually, I was pretty impressed with that. It's a little thinner than they've usually done, but overall the quality of the book itself is pretty good. The story's decent, the art's okay. I thought it was a pretty solid read. I always feel a little bit cheated, but for $4 it was a decent read. It was definitely better than anything Marvel's put out in a long time, except for maybe Venom. This is a book, if you like Predator stories, it looks like it's going to be okay. I don't know anything about these Predator Hunters, and they don't really explain anything till you get to the back where there's this like one page blurb thing. That should have been in the front. Just go to the back and read that first. It'll make way more sense then. I was pretty lost before that. I would definitely say this is a recommend. Maybe not a strong recommend, but if you see it, it might be worth picking up if you like Predator stuff or survival type stories. But that's just my take on it. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you like the video, give it a like, share around, and don't forget to subscribe, and we hope to see you on the next one.